summer is here, so swimmers of all ages are heading up to the North Shore this weekend for the first race in the Surf and Sea North Shore Swim Series. Now, I have our good friend, race director Chris Gardner, here to tell us more. Chris, aloha, man. How you doing?
I am good, man. Thanks for having me on.
I got to ask, you know, this thing just keeps bigger and better every year. How many years has this North Shore Swim Series been going on, and how great is it to see how successful it's been?
Well, Tyza, we're in our 27th year.
Wow.
And, you know, what started out as just kind of a fun thing, a casual swim amongst friends, mm-hmm. has turned into quite the enterprise. So it's crazy how much we've grown.
And it's not so, I mean, you guys have showcasing the North Shore, but it's so cool. You have so many connections with local businesses, groups, swim clubs. Talk about that and that connection and how's that's grown over the years.
Sure, you know, well, we partner with Waikiki Swim Club, who's nonprofit and perpetuates ocean swimming, mm-hmm. primarily. We also work with Malama Pupukea, which protects the Marine Life Conservation District. And we swim through that area,
yeah.
most of the swim races. That's from Waimea all the way to Shark's Cove.
Mm-hmm. And talk about that relationship, though, because, I mean, you're really giving back. You guys make sure that the beaches are clean. I mean, it's really about respecting the environment that we swim in every day.
It is. It's true. And, you know, Tyza, we try to partner with Kahuku High School or Wailua High School as well. A lot of the kids come out and volunteer. And the whole goal is to perpetuate ocean swimming in Hawaii.
Now talk about it. We have some of the great beer. I mean, it's an exciting event. I mean, these are some of the competitors that are in the front there. But for kids, older kids, older adults like me, or just swimmers, I mean, everybody's swimming level comes out to this event. Talk about what people can expect, especially for tomorrow's race.
Well, the first race, the Aloha Salad Summer Sprint, goes from Sunset Beach to Pipeline. So we pretty much like to think it's downhill.
Right.
I mean, you're with the trade winds. Sometimes the current is with you, sometimes it's against you, but it's an easy swim.
Mm-hmm.
And the way it works is generally each swim every 2 weeks gets a little bit longer, culminating with the last swim, which is 2.4 miles.
Mm-hmm. And the great thing I love about your events is the safety, the ocean guards, the lifeguards, everybody's
right
there. I mean, this is, it's in the ocean. I mean, we're out there in nature, but I never once felt I was ever out of my league. You had the ocean guys, you have the race start, you have the course officials. Talk
right
about the event and what people can expect in that.
Well, event. You know, we use Water Patrol Incorporated, the same guys, Terry Ahui and his boys that help Randy Rarick, Marty Thomas with the Triple Crown. So we have the same jet skis, the same lifeguards that are out there for 25, 30-foot surf.
Wow.
Out there protecting our swimmers.
Now, the great thing, I was looking at the waves, you know, the North Shore, a little bit of energy, but it's so different during the summer. It's a great swimming environment. And talk about how many people we can expect for this race tomorrow. And more importantly, people can still sign up for this, right? People can still get out there and enjoy all the race festivities?
Right, they can. So you can sign up at the beach, at Sunset Beach, at the new park there across the street. New park, it's a few years old. But you can come at 7 a.m. till 8:45 and still sign up right on the beach.
Mm-hmm.
As far as the age groups, we had to add a 5-year age group in the older division last
no
year.
No kidding.
Because we had so many guys and girls who were like, well, you know what, the 60-70-year-olds are beating me.
Right.
We want to get an award too. So it's a good problem. They're adding age groups to
it. You know, and I got to ask you, as a race director, and it's been so long, what is it like to see, I mean, you had guys that started this race first, now they have kids, their kids are part of this race. I mean, what's it like for you to see the generations come back and enjoy this race and get bigger and bigger every year?
Well, it's super exciting, and you see the kids that, you know, could barely finish their first year and now they're winning. I mean,
yeah.
Jason and Nicole Hagee,
oh,
they
yeah
were just toddlers when they were coming out. And, you know, we've had a policy where really young kids, if the parents feel they can make the swim, mm-hmm. we make the parents or the coach swim with them.
Oh.
So we try not to even have a lower age group. I
yeah
mean, we're supposed to be technically 8 years old, but we have 6-year-olds that
oh
swim.
Oh, and I've been passed by them. They're great, great athletes. Now, again, we're going to have all this information on our website, but please, if you can't make tomorrow's race, as you were saying, every 2 weeks or so, we have races that continue through Waimea Bay, Chuns, all the way to the big one, the North Shore Challenge at the end. But it's a great way, get up to the North Shore, have a good time, and enjoy the race.
Cap
oh, that's right. Yeah, that's right. Get there early, sign up. You'll
you're
see they have all
up
this. Oh, I'm signed up. So I'll be there tomorrow, and you'll see me with my bright pink race cap on, having a
in honor
time
of the Filipino divers.
Hey, mahalos, man. Hey, but Chris, mahalos for doing
all
this
right,
such
brother,
a great
see
event.
See you tomorrow morning.
I'll be there.
Thanks,
we'll be
Tyson
there all the way through the North Shore Swim Series. I gotta say, I look pretty good in this. Okay, coming up after the break, we'll wrap things up and tell you what we have in store for you on Monday when Living 808 returns. Very good.
Get you.